Assault with a deadly weapon suspect now being pursued by the LAPD. Right now we're approaching Crenshaw going northbound. Van Ness going northbound right now. And it's a small, that sedan that you see. Reasonable speeds right now, but at some points the suspect was on Crenshaw doing circles. And the LAPD had to follow around. It looked like a merry-go-round. But right now, the suspect is northbound Van Ness, and he's coming out of the area from what was the cross there? It's going to be Florence. Florence, he's going, and now we're turning westbound here. And I apologize that we're so far away. Of course, this pursuit happens to be under the final approach for Los Angeles International Airport. And again, law enforcement was very quick to respond to this. A suspect description went out, and within just a few minutes in the 77th Division of the LAPD, they identified the vehicle, tried to pull him over, and the pursuit was on. So right now, looks like we're going about 50 miles an hour on surface streets, now turning southbound, and the LAPD's got two helicopters overhead. We don't know how many people are inside this vehicle, but at this point, the suspect continues to try and evade officers. I guess if there is a little bit of a silver lining, it's that the streets are very, very empty right now, just not a lot of people on the roadway. And so officers right now have about four or five vehicles with them right now. And it's going to be a right turn on 76th Street, right turn on 76th. And the suspect is now westbound, headed toward the Baldwin Hills. We'll tell you when the suspect gets up to Crenshaw. It's here in about one block. And you can see pit maneuver yet. And we don't know if they've been authorized. But the suspect continues to try and evade authorities. Still westbound across the tracks. Now southbound Crenshaw. And the suspect is now southbound Crenshaw. Look at how empty these streets are. There's just nobody out here right now. So the LAPD has a pretty easy time following them. And, of course, they're not going to ever be able to evade the airships. And certainly they won't be able to outrun the radio. So it looks like it may be coming to an end right now. We'll see the suspect on Crenshaw. Looks like it's pulling into a business here. But we are so far out right now because of the traffic at LAX that, back out to the street now, back out to the street, and now coming northbound on Crenshaw, and into a gas station now. Look at the suspect trying to evade officers, and it is just not possible. So, but luckily, again, nobody out here on the roadway. Suspect now, not very fast, but now hits the gas and looks like might be stopping. Nope, going southbound. We saw a couple of pedestrians there on the street. And I'm going to have to talk to LAX one more time. I apologize. I'm going to have to break away.
Go ahead, Larry. As we continue to follow the suspect wanted for assault with a deadly weapon, LAPD has been in pursuit. And it appears, based on this driver's behavior, that he is in an area that he's familiar with. That's what they often do, is retreat to an area they're familiar with. He's been going in concentric circles in this South LA neighborhood now for the last several minutes. We've been tracking this since the top of the hour. He has been driving through red lights at times, but we have not seen extremely high speeds at this point. Erratic driving, yes, but not extremely high speeds. And again, the roads are virtually empty. Because of the curfew that is in effect across Los Angeles County. You're only out if you're going to or from work or have a medical emergency or if you are an essential worker. And this is why we see the streets virtually empty tonight. And this driver zigzagging as though he's trying to shake something free from the car. We don't know if the driver is the lone occupant of the vehicle at this point. Again, assault with a deadly weapon. LAPD in pursuit on the ground with two units and again with pedestrians waving at this driver, and you can see the gestures as though they are familiar with each other, which is what you can assume at this point, although officers, of course, take nothing into assumption. They assume the worst and will continue to proceed with all options on the table. We have not seen a pit maneuver At this point, we have not seen spike strips. We have seen a close following and a driver that continues to evade, not at extremely high speeds, which is good.
Right, but he's certainly going in circles. This is the second time around these streets, and he seems to, like you said, know the area pretty well. And we do have about four or five LAPD cruisers behind him, one that, as you see, is tailing him pretty closely. And you're just wondering if maybe perhaps he's gotten the authorization just yet to do a pit maneuver. And there you do see some more motorists on the road as he blows through that intersection and then again goes down here.
Did it go westbound?
And, now past that alley where he went through originally twice and making his way down. We're trying to get more from Larry Welk as far as a exact location here in South LA where he is, because he has a better idea from the maps up there, but he's also a little bit far away because he's near LAX airspace and has to talk with them for a minute. But again, we do have a curfew in effect, and we do also see people that are going around. Here we go again around that Fatburger, and he is, or is that a gas station?
Okay,
sorry, that
I'm
is
back with you.
Yeah, that is a gas station.
I'm sorry,
he's
about
going
that.
Back down here into this alley. And Larry, do we know if they've been authorized to do a pit maneuver?
They have not. They have not been authorized for a pit yet, and unfortunately, due to the airspace, we are going to have to stay very far away from this pursuit because it's now eastbound Slauson, but the LAPD has two helicopters in there. And believe it or not, even though we were under the COVID-19 being isolated from people, and we understand that there's not a lot of air traffic, for some reason, there is an airline traffic jam right now coming into LAX, and that is preventing us from getting any further south than we are right now. So apologize for the long distance, but again, a very dangerous situation. If you're if you live in this neighborhood and you hear the sirens, especially with what we've all been going through over the last couple of weeks, this is simply one of those Los Angeles pursuits that happens. And not anything that is related to any kind of protest or any kind of demonstration. So at this point, the suspect still trying to evade officers. We're going to have to stay out here to a distance here and try and keep up with it from outside of the LAX airspace. So okay, and we understand now that they have done the pit maneuver. You were just asking about that. And so this pursuit is now over. We'll try and get a view of it, but unfortunately, we had to leave the airspace. I apologize. Oh, still going.
Still going. Yeah.
They tried to pit him, and it's still going. There goes the suspect. So, like I said, we're going to hold on to this as long as we can. There's a couple of pedestrians there. Red light, and now the suspect coming back. And it looks like they may have thrown a spike strip. That's what it looked like to me. Oh, the car fishtailing now coming right at us, northbound. And again, a very tough situation for LAPD, even though there aren't a lot of cars on the roadway. I don't know if there's an LAPD car right there. And I don't know if they're gonna try and slow this thing down right around a car that was at a red light. And it looks like that Cadillac is turning back into that gas station. We may get it's on Slauson again, but we may try another pit maneuver here. That's what it looks like they're gearing up for. It looks like they've got a supervisor's vehicle there. And this thing, there's the pit. And that one looked like it was a good pit maneuver. And look how quickly the LAPD moves in. And now, I don't know why they're pulling away, but the suspect has the car in reverse. Again, it's an assault with a deadly weapon suspect, and that car might be the deadly weapon. And now the suspect has the door of the vehicle open. Officers getting cover behind some of the other cars that are coming up right now. And we'll see how this thing ends. The suspect still not out of the vehicle. Lights.
Looks like he just got out. Looks like he just got out and has
the
hands up. Yeah, just next to the driver's door there. Obstructed by that telephone pole.
Yep. Another pursuit comes to an end here. And we didn't see any other vehicles involved. It looked like a successful pit maneuver. We don't know how many suspects inside that car. But it looks like the suspect now has his arms up in the air and is complying with officers.
Wow, is that something? This driver made it predictable for officers, and they were able to formulate a strategy. I mean, he drove in this little area here, just a couple of blocks down the same alley, five or six times, the same U-turns, the same moves, the same behaviors. And they finally decided that he wasn't going to do it continuously ad nauseum, and they took action. And we saw one pit maneuver there in the alley that was unsuccessful, and finally another one. And with so few cars and pedestrians on the road, they had more opportunity than they typically would on a surface street in a situation like this. That suspect now out of the vehicle with the hands up, complying as far as we can see. Obviously, it's a difficult angle from the shot due to LAX air traffic and final approach. And so our helicopter is at some distance, but you can see the suspect now sitting, apparently. Yeah, it looks like he's sitting on the hood of that car. I have never seen officers give that command, so whether that's something he's decided to do on his own volition, you would have to believe at this point that they would either have him prone on the ground or backing toward those officers. So at this point, it seems like something of a standoff with officers.
Right, we're gonna stay on this for a second here as we try and wait for him to be put. Wait for him to get into custody, be put into custody. You do see some people there behind the police cruisers. For a second there, it looked like they may know the suspect. They were waving, they had their hands up, and looked like they wanted to get a better, you know, view of the scene. But here we do have the suspect now on the hood of his car. His hands are up. He's having a conversation with the officers. We're trying to get a little bit closer, but as we mentioned, we are having a little bit of difficulty having to stay there. Now he's moving away from the car. Looks like the cops are moving in.
0204, Roger.
Yeah, this is not should be going. Yeah, no, he's the foot bail. And now it is a foot chase, and this isn't going to last. You've got dozens of officers converging, and this suspect trying to run. It's hard to say. Too many buildings, too much obstruction, but now officers stopping traffic, and you have to believe that they have him in custody. That would be the assumption from our vantage point, based on the actions of these officers that we can see, and just the sheer number of officers that had him cornered as he ran along that sidewalk. Boy, what a bizarre end to this pursuit. It looked as though that vehicle was disabled, which you'd have to believe would be what would cause him to stop at that point, based on his prior actions and the attempt pit maneuvers that were unsuccessful. And the driver continued to go and continued to go till he couldn't go anymore. And as we saw him get out of the car, as officers asked him to do. And at that point, he had his hands up, standing there for a couple of minutes, and then we saw him sit on the hood of the car, which is not something officers would ask a suspect to do. As they approached him, he turned and ran. And I believe what we see now is the end of this.
Right. Right behind that sign is where the suspect is on the ground and being cuffed, and then will be put into this police cruiser there. You did see some looky-loos and pedestrians that are also there on the corner that were talking to police, and one of them was doing push-ups. I'm not sure, but, you know, looks like they may be friends with him, because they, every time he went around the corner, they were there on the corner and waving at him, and he was having, the suspect in the car was having a conversation with them, it looked like. But it's past curfew, so you're hoping that they told him to go home, and that's the end of it. But again, if you're out and not, as Micah mentioned, and as per the rules for LA County, if you're out and about without the intention of going to and from work or an emergency, the tendency will be to arrest you for being out after 6 p.m. as there a curfew is in effect. And there we do have the suspect in custody.
Yeah, didn't listen to the commands, tried to run, and officers caught him quickly. And he is under arrest, and this pursuit is over.